Mahatma Gandhi supposedly once remarked that Western civilization would be a good idea, suggesting that the West was backward and uncivilized. Well, Gandhi was wrong. The West is the best. Why do you think everyone wants to move here? But when they do move here, they bring the worst aspects of their own culture with them and create ghettos, supplanting the original culture. The left then supports and encourages these ghettos because they believe in cultural relativism, this idea that all cultures are equal. Well, they're not. Some cultures are clearly better than other cultures. 620 million Indians, half of their population, defecate in public. UNICEF has to run campaigns teaching them how to use toilets. Public defecation causes bacterial infections, which lead to childhood malnutrition and death. Indians shitting and pissing in the street is part of their culture. The government also has to put up signs everywhere telling them not to litter, because Indians aren't generally too fussed about cleanliness. That's why India is widely regarded as a shithole. Shitting in public also seems to be popular amongst many of the Muslim migrants now arriving in Europe. Universities and other institutions are also having to teach them how to use toilets properly. Shitting in public is not acceptable. I don't care if it's part of your culture. Shitting in public is bad. Some cultures are better than others.
That's crazy!
In Afghanistan, police officers and military commanders like to rape young boys. The practice is called bacha bazi, literally boy play. Raping young boys is part of their culture. When US Marines blew the whistle and tried to intervene, they were told by higher-ups to look the other way because it's, quote, part of their culture. The New York Times reported on how US troops in Afghanistan would hear the boys screaming as they were being raped by Afghan police who had brought them on base. Raping boys is not acceptable. I don't care if it's part of your culture. Raping boys is bad. Some cultures are better than others. In Israel, Orthodox Jews suck babies' penises. The practice, known as Metzitzar Pei, involves rabbis performing oral suction circumcisions on 8-day-old babies. They suck the baby's penis to cleanse the wound following circumcision. Sucking babies' penises is part of their culture. The practice has caused 17 cases of infant herpes in New York since the year 2000, including 2 deaths. Sucking babies' penises is not acceptable. I don't care if it's part of your culture. Sucking babies' penises is bad. Some cultures are better than others.
That's crazy!
In China, South Korea, and Taiwan, people like to eat tiger penises because they think it's a potent aphrodisiac and it prevents erectile dysfunction. There's no scientific evidence at all to support that claim. Tiger penis is a delicacy served in restaurants in parts of China and Southeast Asia. Eating tiger penises is part of their culture. Demand for tiger penises creates a market for poachers. As Chinese immigration to the West has increased, tiger penis remedies are now available in some European countries. According to the EIA, one tiger every single day is killed for its use in traditional Chinese medicine. Tigers are endangered. There are less than 4,000 tigers left in the wild. Eating tiger penises based on some bullshit belief that it's an aphrodisiac is unacceptable. I don't care if it's part of your culture. Eating tiger penises is bad. Some cultures are better than others.
That's crazy!
In sub-Saharan Africa, there are millions of modern-day slaves. In India, there are as many as 14 million slaves. In Mauritania, as many as 20% of the population is enslaved. Slaves! People being bought and sold. People being compelled to perform forced labor under threat of violence. Even at the height of slavery in the West, only 1.4% of white Americans owned slaves. But we're still being lectured about how evil we are despite the fact that the West was the first to end slavery. Where's the outcry over the 30 million people who are enslaved right now across the world? But I guess just owning slaves is part of their culture, right? Slavery is unacceptable. I don't care if it's part of your culture. Slavery is bad. I'm proud to say that it was the West that ended slavery virtually everywhere else, but it still persists in some parts of Africa and India. Some cultures are better than others.
That's crazy!
Listen, I'm not saying there aren't good things that we can take from other cultures, and I know that Western culture isn't perfect. But it's the best we've got. In terms of individual freedom, economic prosperity, intellectual advancement, technological progress, the arts and medicine, the West provided the blueprint for the ascent of humanity. The West is also the most tolerant place in the world towards other cultures, and invites them with open arms, even at the risk of obliterating itself. So why are we constantly browbeaten into being ashamed of the West? I'm not ashamed of democracy. I'm not ashamed of the Renaissance. I'm not ashamed of the Enlightenment. I'm not ashamed of how the West ended slavery. I'm not ashamed of coming from the most tolerant place on the planet. Look at the fruits of Western civilization. An increase in health, wealth, comfort, freedom, and life expectancy unparalleled in human history. That's why we shouldn't be ashamed to defend Western civilization against cultural relativism. We shouldn't be bullied into sacrificing our own culture and allowing it to be supplanted by inferior cultures in the name of political correctness. The West is the best, but it's only going to remain that way if we safeguard what made it great in the first place.